So the way we're approaching this is we're really trying to come at this from two perspectives, from the perspective of the deer, where we're trying to look at fawn survival and cause-specific mortality, what things are killing these fawns, and then we're also looking at it from the perspective of the predator. So in order to do that, we have to first capture white-tailed deer. And capturing fawns in this forested environment can be tough because it's just hard to find them. So what we do is we capture the adult does in the wintertime, we capture them in box traps, and we have an ultrasound so we can determine right on site whether that doe is pregnant. If the doe is pregnant, we fit her with a radio collar, and then we also insert a vaginal implant transmitter into the birth canal, and that transmitter stays in the doe until she gives birth. And when that transmitter comes out with a fawn, it gives us not only an indication of where the birth event occurred, but also when that birth event occurred. And it allows us to go in and then search for those fawns and try to capture them as young as we possibly can, because bad things happen to fawns in the first few days of life. So you want to get out there very quickly or you're going to miss some of the mortality.
They'll stash them up to a couple hundred meters from where they're feeding. So this was pretty close to where she was, but there could be another one within 200 meters. That's why we searched 200 meters. They found it in the last phase up to that far away from the mother.